Hey everyone, before we begin the video, I just want to bring this up real quick. Apparently something rather tragic and depressing has happened in my life. So if you're all wondering what has happened, around Tuesday, I was just putting gas in my car like a normal human being. And then once I got back in the car, I accidentally ripped my shorts, my khaki shorts. That's right, I have lost one of my favorite shorts of all time. Please, everyone, gather around as we mourn and pay tribute to my lost khaki shorts. Everyone, please take the time, remove your hats, and let's have a moment of silence. Okay, now that that's over with, let's begin the video. What's up, guys? It's me, Dan, and wow, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, this is a big, big video for today on a very specific big topic. For those of you who don't know what I'm talking about, well, you've read the title by now. Loki just ended very big. Oh my gosh. I did not expect this show to surprise me whatsoever, but it did. Now, I'm going to be pretty honest with you. Coming into the show, I was not really that excited about seeing this Loki show. I'm going to be very 100% with you. Before then, I was like, oh, why are you going to make a show about Loki? Like, the dude died. Like, so you're basically making a prequel show, sort of. Sort of a prequel show where you just erase his character development that he's had. You erase every trust that he had to go through, or every development that he had to go through, to earn Thor's trust and his father's trust as well. I was like, really? We have to do that all over again? Really? But no. Episode 1. They did that all in episode 1. And he had time to grow. He had time to develop. He had the time to develop into a whole new character. And I gotta say, props to Team Marvel for what they did to this character. It's not the same villainous Loki that we're all used to. This is a whole brand new Loki. A whole new Loki. I'm not gonna sing the rest because I might get copyrighted for Disney for this song. Sorry, I don't want to. but anyways, the cast was great as well. Owen Wilson is a fan favorite for a reason. And for those of you who were wondering, no, I don't really pay attention. I don't think he once said wow in any of these episodes, which is pretty fine. And Sylvie, man. Sylvie was a great addition. She started off as this like lonely kid who just wants vengeance all his her life. She's basically anti-Loki, sort of. Without the mind tricks, without the illusions and all that stuff. But she was a great character. Very snarky, very, very, very well liked, very well rounded, very dynamic. Everything you want in a supporting character. And I know a lot of people may see it like, oh, she was just there to be a girlfriend to Loki. No, I don't see that. Correct me if I'm wrong, but she's not a character from the comics, am I right? She takes some inspiration for some of the characters from the mythology, from the Norse gods, right? Something like that. And, oh my gosh. That last episode with that surprise character, and this is the part where I'm going to spoil things. If you haven't seen it, too bad. Log off right now, go watch it before, and then come back here. The introduction of Kang. Well, they didn't really confirm it's Kang, the Conqueror, but, you know, they referred to him as He Who Remains. But we all know it's Kang. We all know that Kang's gonna come into play. Wow. when he introduced himself through that elevator, I knew he was gonna be a likable villain. Everything about him was just cherry on the top. I love this dude as soon as he came onto the screen. Wow, like, he's very snarky, he's very intelligent, and like, he's basically the alt, he's like the, this alien troll that belittles these two characters, Loki and Sylvie. He's a very charismatic. He's very, well, dynamic. Oh my god, he's everything you want to be in the villain. Challenging. And he's, so far they're setting him up as the next big thing after Thanos. Even more challenging than Thanos. Oh my god, I can't wait to see what they do with this character. As if I'm correct, there's going to be more variants. Like, more multiverse kings threatening the main timeline. Well, sure, they covered that in the last episode of Loki. But I'm excited. I'm excited to see. And I know some people pointed out the alligator Loki. That's the most random character I've ever seen. Alligator Loki. What? It's funny. It's cute. It's funny. I liked it. I liked it. I liked his addition. I wish we would have gotten more of him. But I feel like we're going to get more of him in the season 2. Which, by the way, yes, they did announce season 2. I'm excited for that. And honestly, throughout the my overall review of this whole series and for the finale for as well, it got, well, episode 1 was a little, episode 1 was a slow start, but as the series went on, it got better and better and better and better and better and more interesting. Sure, there were some confusing elements that I had, which mainly explains, you know, the TVA's decision to bring in variants from breaking the timeline rules. Because even then, I'm thinking, you know, and a lot of people point this out, that Captain America broke a lot of rules when he went back in time in Endgame. And not even just Captain America. Thanos! Where were these guys when Thanos jumped forward through time into the main timeline when he attacked the Avengers base? Where were these guys, huh? That's what I wanted to know. But luckily, we got most of our answers. It's not 100%, but it's there. And, you know, you just kind of feel satisfied in some way. So anyways, what's next? Well, like I said, season 2 is coming. And we're definitely going to get more of the multiverse. Especially with, like, movies in Doctor Strange, Spider-Man. Well, I don't know what else. I guess the Eternals may touch up on the multiverse in some capacity. I don't know. It's a confusing element in their story as well. I forgot, Ant-Man might cover this as well. Since, you know, they just announced Kang is going to appear as the main villain in there. Which is pretty interesting. All I know is that, you know, Mobius doesn't remember who Loki is, which kind of surprised me at the end of the finale. So I feel like they're going to try to fix the TVA in some capacity in season 2. That's my take on it. They're going to try to take... they're going to delve more deeper into the TVA as well, at least from what I feel. I don't know. It's pretty interesting. What do you guys think? Leave a comment down below and give it a like, and mostly subscribe if you want. I'm not going to force you if you want. And yeah, just comment down what you think is going to happen next. That's it for the video. I'm excited for what's to come. Hopefully we get more of Kang. Hopefully we get more of Alligator Loki. But either way, have a good day. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye. Go Loki.